I'm going to show you how to perform cross-tabulation and chi-square test using IBM SPSS. Basically, we use these techniques if we want to test whether there is a relationship between nominal or categorical variables. For example, here we have two variables, age group and income categories. We can see that these variables are measured on ordinal scale, and both of them have 5 different levels. So, if we would like to decide whether there is a relationship between these two variables, we should use cross-tabulation and chi-square test. To do this manually, we should click on Analyze menu and look for descriptive statistics, and after that click on Crosstabs. Okay, so basically the output of cross-tabulation is a table called Contingency table, which contains the data across the two variables. So we can see the distribution of the data between those categories. So first of all, we have to decide which variable we want to see as rows and columns of the contingency table. For example, I put age group as rows and income category as columns of the contingency table by using these arrows. The second thing is that chi-square test is not performed automatically by SPSS, so we have to look for doing it. So we should click on statistics menu here and ask for chi-square here. Continue. And it is also recommended to calculate the row percentages of this table, because tendencies may become a bit more visible in this way. So we should click on cells and ask for row percentages. Okay, continue. After all of these, we can click OK. And here is our output table. In this area, we can see the contingency table. From this table, it is clear that there are many young people with low income and lots of senior people with high income. So we should say that there is some relationship between income category and age group. To test this formally, we should use chi-square test. The null hypothesis of this test claims that there is no relationship between the variables. So, if we reject the null hypothesis, we claim that there is some relationship between the variables. Now, we can see that the p-value is lower than 0.05 here in the third column of the table that contains the result of the test. So we can conclude that there is a relationship between age group and income categories. So That's all for today. Thanks for watching.